Hello, my name is Jimmy Walter. Like everyone else, I watched the planes hit the World Trade Towers and I watched them collapse. Like everyone else, I thought it was the impact of the planes and the ensuing fires that caused the collapse. Like everyone else, I became concerned with terrorism. I went onto the internet and started researching the foreign newspapers and articles that were appearing there, but were not making the light of day in the American mainstream press, or were buried on page 88 in a small and usually misleading headline. What I discovered was that not only did Saddam Hussein not have weapons of mass destruction, did not have poison factories, but in fact fought tooth and nail in the New York Times, USA Today, various alternative newspapers across the country. I was censored by the LA Times. I was ignored by everyone. I shut up when the war started in order to support our troops. After mission accomplished was asserted, I started going around the country to the protests to bring our boys home. There I met Eric Hufschmidt, who had written Painful Deceptions and Painful Questions. I got his book and video, but never gave him the time of day. At worst, I thought 9/11 was a sin of omission, where the administration had let it happen in order to further their own nefarious world domination purposes. I did not believe that the World Trade Center was brought down with explosives. About 6 months later, a friend cajoled me into watching Eric's video. It was an epiphany. I knew after watching his video that towers had been brought down with explosives. When I saw heavy steel beams flying straight out, some of them actually going up and down, trailed by a smoke cloud of poisonous debris, I knew that it had to be explosives. Please watch the following video of the event I produced on September 11th of 2004 in New York City, which follows. And see, as they say in The Matrix, how deep this rabbit hole goes. I really do feel like I took the red pill. Brace yourself. You're in for a rude awakening.
I'm Ed Begley, Jr. How are you all this evening? Thank you for coming. I'm going to be your host for this evening's program. Welcome to Confronting the Evidence, a call to reopen the 9/11 investigation. I'll be your host for this evening's program. I'd like to ask you please to finish taking your seats as we're going to begin in a moment. I don't need to tell you that tonight marks the third anniversary of the September 11th events. To begin tonight's program, we ask you to join us in a tribute to the fallen, if you will.
Thank you.
We're going to hear from a lot of people this evening. We have a very distinguished panel, but right now I would like to bring out Jamie Hecht, my co-host for this evening. Jamie, would you come out here?
Thank you.
Why does so large a group of people believe that the violence, the bereavement, and the grief inflicted on September 11th, which have had such permanent and ongoing consequences, some of which we can't foresee, was avoidable? That it wasn't a bolt out of the blue, some cosmic blow against humanity that should cause us all to bow our heads, remember the fallen, and then go back to business, or as we were urged to do at the time here in New York City, to go out and shop. Why have the questions posed by the families and by the independent researchers, some of whom you'll meet tonight, and so many of you, gone unanswered? In the next few hours, we shall embark upon a difficult journey. And we ask you to reconsider the horrifying events of September 11th in a new and troubling light. This journey is quite difficult. It requires that we re-examine some of our most basic beliefs. This requires overcoming a special kind of inertia, which we're rarely asked to move. And yet, the rewards are a change from anxiety to awareness, from passivity and quietism to a more full participation in the most urgent issues of our time, diminishing unnecessary harm and bringing people closer together for a world of possible safety and creativity and understanding.
If this is your first exposure to this material, you may feel very uncomfortable with that and challenged to confront your prior assumptions about September 11th. If you've already been exposed to these issues, you'll see that there are many things you want to look at. We have a large group of gifted researchers. Some of them have been questioning the official story of 9/11 from the very first day after the attacks. The questions these researchers have raised has been the subject of countless articles, discussions initiated by citizens in their homes. And there's been official silence by the commercial media about these events. But we've had a tremendous impact on what people have thought. Last month, a representative poll commissioned by Zogby found that about half of the city's residents do not believe that the attacks came by surprise. 41% of New York residents. Half.
That's 49.3% of residents of New York City and 41% of New York State residents. And the question is, how could that view be so pervasive?